Hi, Nathan Smith here. Today we're going to myth bust ultrasonic sound, as well as why transparent microphones are ideal. Let's talk about ultrasonic sound. The myth that only a handful of things have ultrasonic frequencies is not true. How do I know? Well, after recording for the last 7 years daily, I can assure you that basically everything produces ultrasonic frequencies. It's true that some things project more ultrasonic sound than others, but with a capable microphone and microphone placement, just about everything produces ultrasonic frequencies. Now, when it comes to recording ultrasonic sound, most analog microphones, or all that I've ever used, come with ultrasonic noise as well. The one exception is when using a Shure CMD42, where there is no ultrasonic noise present from the microphone itself, as we can see from this recording using a Sanken 100K alongside the CMD42 with an Omni Shure MK2H. The CMD42 sounds great played back at any speed, whereas the Sanken is known to not sound that great at normal speed. This is why you often see recordists use the Sanken 100K as an additive or additional microphone. Let's go over things to know about microphones and ultrasonic recording. Let's talk about the effect or change of a microphone's polar pattern as frequency rises. Even when you're recording with an omnipolar pattern, as you get higher in the frequency, the pattern becomes more cardioid and then supercardioid in shape at the highest frequencies. This is why mic placement is important, to be in direct field when recording and not off axis. Let's talk about the effect of reverb. When you slow a sound down by 50%, you're effectively doubling the length of the size of the reverb in your recording, so you often want to record in a space with minimal reverb. You need to be mindful of unwanted ultrasonic noise when you're recording. In general, large diaphragm microphones are less successful than smaller size diaphragm microphones. Figure 8 polar patterns are limited and often don't capture much usable data over 20,000 kHz, whereas omnipolar patterns are the most successful at capturing ultrasonic sound. So now let's talk about the value of transparent microphones and how they can play a role in capturing better ultrasonic sound. With a transparent, rotationally symmetric microphone, when pitching or changing the speed of a recording, the EQ profile remains consistent, meaning the process or color effect you add in post are effectively the same when applied at different playback speeds. Because of the off-axis is not colored, recording in different spaces does not affect your recording as much as a colored microphone, resulting in more consistent recordings. The profile of a colored microphone can also be a problem when denoising, since the off-axis and on-axis information has different EQ characteristics. And when denoising, you can only profile the total recorded sound, effectively applying noise reduction unevenly. This can be more apparent in MS recording, where phase plays a significant role in the total sound image. If you work in non-linear formats, you often layer or have hundreds of sounds playing at the same time, often in many various combinations. If your recordings are colored to start with, the color profile can build up in an unintended way, making for a more complex and messy mix, especially if your goal is to create an acoustically viable sounding mix. Also, when you have a colored mic, that color is locked to the EQ band of said color, So that cool, beefy thing at normal speed no longer sounds the same at a slower speed. Whereas if you learn to add the desired color as a sound designer in post, you now get those results at any playback rate. A microphone with color does have its benefits in some cases, like live shows or in a music recording studio. But for recording source sound for sound design, I find there are just too many downsides when using a colored microphone. My choice after years of trying different microphones is the Shure Colette MK series. Its small size makes it easy to fit in small places and able to be well balanced in wind protection at the most ideal location. The flexibility of swapping out an MK4 for an MK41 in an MS setup in the field is very valuable. In general, I'll often use an MK4 for ambience recording and the MK41 for hard effects. When using Shure microphones, this is how you line up your mics. It's simple. The membrane is where the polar pattern symbol engraving is. So just align the picture of the mic polar pattern. Thank you for joining me on this exploration of ultrasonic sound and transparent microphones.